Dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, I am Father Charles Michael, working in SFS Matriculation School in Viluppuram, Tamil Nadu, India. I wish to share a short reflection on our Heavenly Founder, Father Peter Mary Mermier, who said, "I want missions," as we are in the year of mission. The central theme of our reflection for today is Father Mermier, a mystic and a prophet. First of all, who is a mystic? A mystic is the one who himself is the house of God and rooted in God's love. Thus, God becomes the center of life. Mystics are constantly drawn towards God, who is the source of all being. Mystics impel us to live the mind and heart of Christ. Mystics attribute everything to God and have a discerning heart. Mystics celebrate rationality and communicate God's love and life. Mystics remain serene even in the face of trials and storms of life, more conscious about mission. That is, mission is more important than himself. Now, who is a prophet? A prophet is a mouthpiece of God. Prophets hear the word of God and speak it. God sends prophets to guide people. A prophet bears witness to the kingdom of God, burning with zeal to actualize the vision of God, and they become one with the suffering people. Prophets are committed to the causes and communicate love, truth, and life, etc. Prophets are free from ambitions and attachments, but stand for truth and transparency. How Father Mermier was mystic and prophet? A small story would tell us how Father Mermier was a mystic and a prophet. Once, a woman enjoyed baking bread for her family, as well as made extra for the passers-by. Every day, a hunchback man came and took away the bread. Instead of expressing gratitude, he uttered the following words and went away: "The evil you do remains with you. The good you do comes back to you." This went on for many days. The woman got irritated and planned to keep poison in the bread. However, as she was about to keep the bread on the window, her hands trembled. Immediately, she threw it in the fire and made another one and placed on the window. As usual, the hunchback man came and said the same words without knowing how the woman was irritated. Now, the woman had a son who went to a distant place and never came back for many years. She prayed fervently for his return. That night, there was a knock on the door. She was surprised to see her son, very thin and lean. He was about to die, but today, one hunchback man gave me bread and made me to live again. At this time, she remembered the words of hunchback man, that is, "The evil you do remains with you, the good you do comes back to you." Yes, dear sisters and brothers, the Gospel of Luke chapter 6 verse 45 says the same. The good person produces good and the evil person produces evil. This is very well evident in the life of Father Mermier, especially The French Revolution sparked profound transformations in social, economic, and religious fields. The aftermath of the French Revolution still continued to weaken the faith and practices of Catholics. The post-French Revolution produced a population who were completely indifferent towards God. Thus, the situation in which Father Mermier lived and built up his life was favorable for revamping the gospel values in the lives of Catholics. He heard a call, a challenge to look beyond a parochial state of affairs and move towards to the universal church. As a diocesan priest, Father Mermier used to read the activities of the Jesuit missionaries. He was impressed by the missionaries who went out into the third world countries to spread the gospel message. As a man of profound faith, his heart longed for spreading the good news of Jesus. Yet, he also realized the limitations that a single person alone may not be able to materialize his dream of evangelization to all the countries. Therefore, Father Mermier shared his heart's desire with some of his fellow priests of the same diocese, and he promoted interest in the minds of those priests about the missions. Knowing Father Mermier as a holy man, a few diocesan priests expressed their desire to join him in his missionary venture. Encouraged by the support of his priest friends, he had the aspiration to begin a congregation. The idea of being the founder of a new congregation filled him with great joy. He questioned himself to determine whether such a feeling came from God or human impulse or even a suggestion from the devil. To settle the matter, he sought God's help. With confidence in the providence of God and the sustaining power of the Holy Spirit and the encouraging accompaniment of Jesus, Father Mermier founded the Congregation of the Missionaries of St. Francis de Sales. Father Mermier's life was infused with the perfume of Salesian spirituality and insisted to have the practice of Salesian spirituality by the members. He wanted the MSFS missionary to be a man of vision who builds communities, who explores and ventures into the unknown and sows God's word whenever and wherever possible by following the spirit of St. Francis de Sales. This inspired his every action, and the sanctity of Mermier is revealed in all his activities. He wanted the members of his congregation to be contemplatives in action and mystics of God's love. Every MSFS confrere strives to remain faithful to the yearnings of the founder's heart, to be a missionary with a Salesian spirituality, to be a mystic deeply rooted in our spiritual heritage, and to be prophets, being faithful to the voice of God speaking to us in different ways. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, give us the grace to allow ourselves to be taught daily by your word, so that our lives may become more and more contemplative in action, attentive to the movements of your spirit in us and to his action in the world. Amen.